afternoon, everybody. So sorry we were running a little late. So let's start this next session, an interesting session. Future of marketing. How do you survive and thrive in the age of customer? Digital marketing and social media, and what are the do's and don'ts, and what are the insights around how how do you go about doing your digital marketing? That's what is the theme of the next session. The session is led by Dhaval Gupta. He's the director and head of new initiatives at CyberMedia. And obviously, he has a very keen understanding of media and the technology space. He has played a pivotal role in establishing CyberMedia as a leading digital services setup. And he is the architect of CyberMedia partnerships with Google, Facebook, Twitter, and he also oversees the CyberMedia services. And he's been building comprehensive online branding strategies, audience profiling, big data analytics. So everything to do with digital marketing. Welcome, Dhaval. All yours.
Thank you so much. Everybody can hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Guys, sorry for, there was a little bit of mix-up. So, I 2 minutes back, I was like upstairs just having lunch. And then suddenly I was like, oh no, this session has started. Okay. Came running down. Sorry about the delay. All right, so let me quickly give you a background about CyberMedia and myself. So we're a 36-year-old organization. Digital marketing is something that we've been doing for, actually media services is something we've been doing for 2 decades. Digital marketing, of course, over the last decade has been growing very, very rapidly. And today we provide end-to-end services to brands in the digital marketing space. So all told, what we've done is that we've built a network of digital ads and a whole host of services around it. And on a monthly basis, we're managing over 6 billion ads, right? And what happens when you deal with 6 billion ads is that there's a huge amount of data that is getting collected, right? So each data point ends up generating about, each ad impression generates about 20 key data points. And effectively making sense out of that and converting it into something that is very actionable, insightful, and results in something better as far as the brands is concerned is something that we are working on. So today I'm going to talk about digital marketing overview as an industry. What are some of the trends? What are some of the important questions? So one of the things that I was requested to talk about was the do's and don'ts of marketing. Right? So what we'll primarily end up, I didn't put it as a do and don't list, but I ended up breaking it down into some of the very important questions that are relevant in the marketing space today. Right? And we find when we interact with different brands, many of the people who are thinking about digital marketing are not always asking those questions. Right, so we'll come to that. But before that, of course, this is something I'm sure many of you have seen in the marketing space before, which is new technology is coming up very, very rapidly. And whatever is the old tech, it's taking lesser and lesser and lesser time, almost about 50% lesser for that to hit the next billion users. But what is the big trend, right? So let's say, what is the big next big trend, right? Today we are talking about AI, ML, and by the way, throughout the conference, I'm sure you've heard that plenty of times, so I'm not going to focus on AI, ML too much, or AR, VR. I think those are trends that you as marketers would already be aware. But what are the questions behind it, right? How do we, whatever implementation you tomorrow may do in your AI, how do you arrive at what is valuable? So that's what's going to be my focus. But whatever trend is going to be big needs to hit the next billion. In fact, it's probably going to hit the next 1.5 billion. So in the big trends that are there in the industry, I think that is now the benchmark in terms of what's working and what's not working. Okay. India, of course, is leading the race globally in digital uptake. So very, very quickly, in terms of ad spends across the country, TV, of course, is the biggest one, and in 2018, that's going to continue. Print, steady, a little bit flat. Vernacular, of course, there is growing in double digits, but English medium, staying pretty flat. Digital, of course, there is the big mover, right? So in about 5 years' time, growing from 134 to 435. So a huge, huge jump. But to me, what's very, very interesting is that this is the tipping point when the influence between digital overtakes TV, right? So, I mean, I think in the US that has already happened. And as a trend, that's a very interesting trend to keep an eye out for. But when does digital overtake TV? Today, TV is still very much sort of the big elephant in the room. And you know, we just had another session on that where Meher from Z was talking about this. But I think this is a very, very interesting trend for the future. So, so many platforms, so many things to do. How do we get the right decision making going? Of course, the biggest ones being Google, Facebook, Amazon coming up pretty quickly, and you know, these are the traditional deliverables. So lots and lots of complexity getting built into digital marketing. I think for those who don't understand digital marketing, which are often our consumers, you know, a whole degree of education is something that each and every brand today needs to invest in, because it's not as simple as, okay, let me set up my campaign and run it, right? There is going to be an SEO angle, there's going to be a mobile tech angle, of course, there's going to be data angle. So how do you deal with that, right? So earlier, very simple approach, it was about distribution, and you distributed. And how was it getting distributed, or rather how many people were getting distributed, was a very, very big question mark. But today brands and today marketers can't afford to keep it just as simple, because the data starts to tell us insights and starts to share newer and newer things. So something which is, you know, not very you know, available, or you wouldn't intuitively think of this, is 67% of women have changed jobs or said they would be willing to do so for a better balanced family life. Usually we say that, you know, probably women want to make changes in their jobs because of this, but there's a lot of survey and there's clear data suggesting that it's otherwise. So what used to be the traditional way of thinking and the traditional approach to digital, to marketing, has changed a lot. And the distribution plays a very, very important role here, because you're now starting to track a lot of things, right? And that is going to be very, very critical. So I know future of marketing is one of the things that we are covering. So I'll do this very quickly. Some of you may already be aware, but since I was talking about the data part, right? Whoever has interacted with your brand, what is it that, what is their data telling you, right? I think that is very valuable information. That's very valuable because you not only have the customer has done an interaction, so therefore the customer is choosing to associate with your product, but also tell you about himself or herself in that product, right? So customer match, are you tracking that data effectively, and what are the insights that that data is generating is one end of the spectrum and how you sort of start off. The remarketed traffic, remarketing is of course already big. Facebook platform provides this very easily. But this is also people who may have interacted with your brand but still haven't given your information, right? So that's the next category. People who have yet to interact. So similar user data is something that's very relevant. Demographic data is again also growing very, very rapidly as a medium so that you are able to target in a more effective and intelligent manner. And that's true across all these platforms. So here I'm taking a few assumptions, right? So that everybody in the room is familiar with the platforms that exist, that yes, they do provide these services, that yes, you know, you have a basic setup where your marketing engine is running in the right direction. And therefore, these are the steps that need to be basically kept in mind as a very good starting point. And if you're not doing this, then I would encourage each and every one of you to at least build the funnel so that you start to understand your organization's data very, very effectively, right? So what are the right questions that a marketer should be asking? And I think this is where, based on our interaction with brands, we find that there is a lot of gap. Oftentimes, they're not asking the relevant questions, or they're looking at certain aspects or certain angles of it. But I think this is something that I wanted to focus on. And I think this automatically should give you a list of do's and don'ts at the end of it. So if you start sort of noting these down, we believe that it helps really put together a good system, funnel, understanding of what you want to get out of your marketing objectives, right? First question, are you making the right marketing bets? Right? Big question, open-ended, slightly question. But of course, if you're going to be spending your money, then are you making the right bets? That's a fundamental question that will come back. And what we find are relevant questions within that is, do you have the right partners? I think this is something, particularly in the India market, is very, very critical, very, very important, because there is a lot of misinformation, unfortunately, in our ecosystem, right? So do you have partners who are very good quality partners, and they are trusted partners? Are they in line with your marketing objectives, right? Is their tech in line with what you want to achieve or what you want to push, right? Is your brand marketing stack flexible? So today, we are in an ecosystem and we're in an industry that literally changes every week. Not only the major platforms, but there's new tech coming out all the time. And there's new changes. There are events happening all the time, right? So let's say there is an event, there's something is coming up. And of course, events are now becoming a major part of marketing with your IPLs, election, of course, around the corner is a big activity and so on. You have, as a brand, one has to maintain the flexibility so that whatever is available in terms of offer to your distribution channel can be integrated very, very quickly and made into something very interesting, which can be associated with your brand. Does your marketing dashboard look like your investment portfolio, right? So many of you, I'm sure, manage your investment portfolios. Marketing budgets are something which are still not looked at very scientifically and with a ROI bent of mind. I mean, sure, everybody asks the question, "Haan, mujhe kya ROI milega, kitni lead milengi," and so on. But, you know, I'm sure most of you personally have your investment portfolio where it says, okay, this is my IRR. Unfortunately, marketers don't apply that same thing to their dashboards, right? And I would strongly recommend that you start doing that so that you know where is the balance of payments going and what is the impact that it's driving to your brands. And are you treating your data with respect? Basically, are you securing it well? Are you actually putting it in a, are you warehousing it in an effective manner so that it can be used to make some actionable intelligence out of it? So when I spoke about this particular question, I think it's about getting the basics right, right? And I think these four quantify the primary basics, even if you're starting out. So, I mean, a good, very good checklist to start in terms of what you're doing in the marketing, and I hope I'm giving you some food for thought there. Second question, is your brand maximizing value from its investments or the investments that you're making, right? So, of course, you've put in the money, you've created a dashboard, the data is getting secure, but now you've decided I'm putting in the money, and here's the credit card associated with the Facebook account or bank account or Google account or whatever it is, and you start spending, right? So, the first question that comes to mind today in the digital world is that any user can discover you from anywhere in the world, right? Because discoverability is so demographic, is so democratic, effectively every brand's position on the internet has to be managed by itself. That means that you have to think about the content that you're putting as a brand online. So you have to be a publisher. You have to think like a publisher. What is the user going to interact with? What is the user going to engage with when they come on your website or when they search for you or when they read a review about your product? This is starting to become very, very interesting and very different. Brands usually traditionally have never thought like a publisher. But I think today, more than ever, it is very relevant to start thinking like a publisher and how that can have... it's basically judging a book by its cover. Because on your mobile phone, you're not necessarily going to read the whole book, but you are going to see the review, right? So, and consumers today in the digital space do that, unfortunately. Fortunately or unfortunately. So think like a publisher. What is the content that you need to put out? Are your dashboards providing you the relevant information for quick decision making? I think gone are the days when, you know, it used to be, acha, ye mahine ka, you know, this is my monthly plan. And then at the end of the month, I'll take a decision. These are real-time environments, Because these are real-time environments, the way your system is set up, it should be providing you ideally real-time data, and it should be enabling decision-making that's very quick. It's very, very quick. Maybe not, I mean, real-time is, you need to have the right tech stack to have it really real-time, but irrespective of that, you can really put together a very simple stack of technology that still allows you to do very quick decision making. Earlier I had asked about, you know, do you know what your data is? Here we start asking, what's the value of your data? So now you're capturing your data, you're warehousing your data, you know, the data is sitting in an effective manner, you can analyze your data. But what's the value of the data? So let's say you have 100 data points. Right, which 10 data points are the most valuable data points, which will help you do analysis? And which are the 90, which is probably just noise? Right, so things like that are very important for brands and marketers to really ask and understand to get sort of maximum out of what is the data telling you? What is the data trying to talk to you about? do you have a change evangelist in your system? Right, so this is somebody who understands the ecosystem and can accordingly help make changes. How do we recruit, hire, nurture the right team? This is the question number three. And I don't have a next slide to this question, but I think a mix of different people from different backgrounds is very, very important, right? So somebody who's creative, somebody who definitely has tech background, data background. So today, in any organization, one of the most well-rounded team has to be the marketing team. Okay, how do you drive innovation and stay ahead of the curve? Right? So of course, tech is a big part of this. And how do you continue to make sure that you are relevant as a brand, you are in front of the right audience, and you're competing very, very effectively, right? So these are four questions I put against that. Are you pulling out deeper insights from data? This is where data starts to get really creative, right? You start doing machine learning and things like that, but it's not easy for everybody. But how do you really drive deeper insights? Is your team creative enough? Creativity, there's no substitute to that. Technology will never be able to substitute human creativity. So is your team creative enough? Marketing in real time, I already touched upon this. And what is the success ratio of the experiments that you're doing? So in digital marketing, you cannot deny that because it's such a fast-moving industry, that you won't be able to do in experiments. You have to try new things. Some of them will work, some of them will not work. So what's your testing or experimenting success ratio? Okay. So these are, I think, some important questions, which if put all of these together, really help actually create a very cutting edge, advanced level marketing team, marketing solution, and of course, ultimately the campaigns, right? I'm almost out of time, but I had few slides, so I'll run through them quickly. So of course, ultimately, this is actually a conclusion slide, which is that ultimately there are four pillars of the internet world, right? The four pillars are, you have your content. So content is king, that's where everything begins. Second is distribution, so how do you reach out to the right audience, could be through social media, could be through SEO, whatever may be the term, but what's your reach? The third is the relevance, and in this case, how do you measure relevance? It's through data, right? Data is the third pillar of the internet world, and ultimately all of this put together, which is your content, your data, and your distribution, should lead to e-commerce, and should lead to ROI. So those are the four pillars, and I think that's where marketers should be able to bucket all the functions that they today need in their teams. Very quickly, I wanted to also highlight a few trends. So you know, since we are talking about future, I'm not going to talk about what is, you know, future 5 years away. I'm going to talk about what are the possibilities here and now that you can apply today into your businesses, right? So like I said, AI, ML is not going to be part of that. I think all of you know this, India is home to the second largest online user base, internet users, 50 crore and moving forward. Video, of course, is booming. So video is a massive, massive trend. Video will continue in this direction simply because 4G today allows it. So the very quick number that is, I think, very relevant is up till 3G, the amount of video content that was uploaded from India was very less. Most of the consumption that was happening on 3G for videos was international content. But 4G has made it possible and has allowed Indians to start uploading content very seamlessly. So now, since 4G has come in, not only this points to YouTube viewers, but the amount of video content from India that is being uploaded is massive. So, and it's like a hockey stick, you know, it's just gone like that. E-commerce, of course, online shoppers, so the number of active online shoppers, this is as per June data, 10 crores, so that number is growing very strong. And 4G users, so all mobile phones, already over 21% of users are 4G. Mobile first economy, there's, I think, very little to explain in this, but India is the first mobile superpower in the world, right? And it's going to continue being that. In 28% increase in mobile share, which has also led to reduced time spent per visit, but this is going to be a continuing trend as far as mobile is concerned. This is something that we try and break up some of our campaigns in. I want to know moments, I want to go moments, I want to do moments, I want to buy moments. This is actually, I'm stealing this a little bit from Google, but I think this encapsulates what are some of the moments that you want to capture on the phone. Because of the time is getting reduced and the window of opportunity is getting reduced, the decision making is when you really, really want to capture this. Programmatic is a big, big part of this industry, and it's going to continue growing in a massive way, right? So programmatic is where there is more automation happening, where everybody's digital inventory starts becoming available online. And you don't need a media planner or media buyer to tell you what is right or wrong. It'll allow you to have that data available at your fingertips, plan your campaigns accordingly. So programmatic is a big, big part of the future. And very quickly, this is a visual. So right now there's traditional media, and then there's open auction, which is the Google bidding system, right? And there's a lot more in the middle, which most of the ecosystem, I can guarantee more than 90% of the ecosystem is not familiar with it. So there's a lot more in terms of marketing strategies and marketing trends that you can build out to get better ROI for your campaigns. Customer match, if you have your offline data, marry that with your online data, because that's going to make it very powerful. So customer match is simply, if you have your CRM data or your offline data, mix it with your marketing campaigns, and it'll give you very good, very, very good response. It started to give you really intelligent insights. Video I spoke about, content marketing is the last slide, and content marketing, I again come back to where I started, which is content is king. And so if as a brand you're not investing well in terms of what is the content you're putting out, how do you come in front of the decision makers, which are your customers, then you're really missing out. So content and content marketing is something that I think should really invest in. And with that, I think my time is, I've in fact overextended my time, but thank you for listening. And so I think over to you.
Thanks, Dhaval, for that insightful session and how to make some sense and order into all the multiple digital marketing channels that we have today. I'll request Atulji to hand over a small memento.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you. In case of any questions, I'm here, so.
Yeah. He'll be available. If you have any questions, you can take them. He can take them offline.
Thank you.